singing song. Is he really that great? Is he really that great? He's a great God. He's a great God. He's a great God. He's better than Gatorade. He's a thirst quencher. He's better than Mr. Clean. He can wash you white as snow. He's a great God. How you know, Apostle Simmel? Because I was a ratchet and dumb. On my way to hell, and he reached down and pulled me out and said, son, you ain't got to go there. What a great God. Could have had AIDS, could be dead. What a great God. I pity the fool that won't serve him. I pity the fool that won't give a life to him. I pity the fool. You ain't even got to have money to have him to love you. You could be homeless and he'll still receive you when your friends won't. He's a great God. Let me go and get this started. It ain't no use of me playing with such a well-cooked meal. You know, when he said the table is spread, well, some of y'all ain't ready to eat, but I'm ready. St. John, the 3rd chapter. What a great God. I remember my body was racking with pain, couldn't stand the cold, went from 245 to 177, and the doctor still ain't found out what was wrong with me. But I sit down and talk to Dr. Jesus. I said, look at him, God. I know I accepted this, but I know you can reverse this. Do what you do, God. He said, Terry, I'm a game changer. I can change the baddest thing. He said to me, I'm a game changer. People thought I had cancer. People thought I was finna die. They thought the world was over for me. And I talked to the man that got all power in heaven and earth. I said, Jesus, I need you to come down and see about me. That's why I love him so much. That's why I love him so much. That's why I love him so much. There's none like him, y'all. Blood sugar was 489. They told me I was a diabetic. I ain't took no medicine yet. Ain't none like him, y'all. Ain't none like him. Ain't none like him. I searched all over, couldn't find nobody. I look high, I look low, still couldn't find nobody. He's good all by himself. When you got Jesus, you got more than enough. You don't need no bank. You don't need no new house. You don't need no car. All you need is Jesus. He told me he's a game changer. You're a bad man. Blood sugar 489. And ain't took no diabetic medicine yet. Then they turned around and told me that I had a heart attack. I said, who had a heart attack? He said, you don't have a heart attack. I told him, doctor, not me. They did a casting. And the doctor said, that man got a perfect heart. And y'all tell me I won't serve him. But you must be born again. These things don't happen for everybody. You must be born again. You must be his child. People going to church all this morning and don't even know God. They're just filling up the church. Every church around here is full. And sin is everywhere. Sin is all in the church. Punks and sissies, all in the church. Preachers crooked, everything. And we go just to go to church. I'm gonna tell you what our problem is. Can I talk to y'all? Cause I'm gonna preach like he want me to preach. But he already got me. I'm gonna tell you what our problem is. He said, you all fear God for what he might do to you. But you all don't reverence him because who he is. Y'all fear him because what y'all think he gonna do to you. Y'all come to church because y'all don't wanna go to hell. But y'all don't want to change y'all life. The cross did it all for me. It changed all my situation. I heard y'all out here talking about the source of all love. He didn't say some love. He said, I'm the source of all love. So even if you ain't with me, I'm still the source of what you're trying to do. I'm still the source of your love. But I didn't hear nobody out here say that he was a source of forgiveness. That's what love do. Love makes you forgive. That's how we got a right to make it to heaven. Because God sent his son to show a source of love to take our sin and die for us. To forgive us. He the source of all love. Something or someone, something to provide what you want. A need. But that don't work for you. Because you come back and say, St. John 14, 15 said, if you love me, that's the only way I can be your source. You got to do what my word said. He said, if a man love me and keep my commandment, I am his source. And if he abide in me and I abide in him, he can ask for whatever he will. Some of y'all can't ask for nothing because y'all not abiding in his word. God say I'm a healer, you say he ain't. You'd rather go to a regular doctor and get endorsed than to come to Jesus and say, what's wrong with me? What's the problem? Lay hands on yourself. He said he's already a healer. Well, if that's the same God, if that's the same God, well, Malachi 3 and 6 said, for I am the Lord, and I change it not. The same God in Hebrews 13, 8, said I'm the same yesterday and today forevermore. What I did back then, I can do it right now. You already got a better covenant with me. You got my son. I better go and read this scripture. I better go on and read it. But let me just sit in. Y'all go ahead. You cannot be born again and believe the Bible is corrupted and contain falsehood. Not being born again. See, too many of us doubt the Bible because we ain't born again. We think the Bible is corrupted. We think the Bible is falsehood. We want to say Jesus was black to make identify with us. But he told me I had to be a spirit to identify with him. He that worship me must worship me in spirit and truth. He ain't say I got to be color. And some of y'all the devil already got some of y'all. Because the devil aims today is to keep you away from the Bible, to keep you away from truth. His aim is to pull you away from truth. That's why Pensacola can't come here, because the devil keeping them away from truth and keep them in their favor where they telling them stories at. How can a person shacking, hoeing, having sex gonna make it to heaven? How a sister directing a choir gonna be right when I got this, all these little boys got to watch a sister direct the choir? What they gonna think, sister's all right? It ain't all right with God, it ain't all right for the church. 2 Corinthians 13 and 8 said, for we can do nothing against the truth. Nothing against the truth. Nothing against the truth. I don't care what Trump said. I don't care what Obama say. Same-sex marriage is right. Right? Oh, okay. That what the church saying now. The church is going along what the United States said. Could I give y'all something here? Alcohol leave you breathless. Drug leave you senseless. Evil leave you heartless. Death leave you lifeless. But Jesus won't leave you regardless. Us. He's a great God. He's a great God. I don't see why no man won't serve him. I just don't see why. I just don't understand. He been good to me, y'all. He been good to me. I don't know about y'all, but he ain't failed me yet. I love him too, y'all. I love him. For real, I do. That's why I'm coming today to preach hell about you. Don't think y'all gonna keep me praising that I ain't gonna preach hell about you. You can drop, you ain't got to get no money, you ain't got to bring no money. I just want your ear for a few minutes. Because the truth demand a change, and most of us in here hadn't changed. The truth demand a change. It don't matter you to come in here and hear the truth all like we hear the truth and still live the same. A lot of us sitting here don't hear the truth and still hadn't changed. The truth, it demands a change. It don't even care if you want a change. It says stop shacking. It says stop being a hoe. It says stop smoking. It says stop drinking. It says stop having enough of sex. The truth demands a change. Well, there's truth, Apostle Simmel. The real fact about something, the things are true. Demand a forceful statement. We want somebody to sit here and tell her, you going to heaven anyhow. Come on. We got people sitting up in church talking about getting the promise of God in sin all the way from the head to the foot. The promise of God is not for a sinner. The promise of God is for the righteous man. Because truth demands a change. You healed, Annie, baby. That's my baby. She healed. The Bible tells us in Hebrews 6, 4 and 6, it says, for it is impossible for those who once have been enlightened, once have got the word, once have heard the word, one time were walking right with God, once enlightened, not two. That's why he said, the day that you hear my voice, harden not your heart. He said, once. People don't came in here, people don't hear it 8 years of nothing but word. And then walked away from God. This is what he said. For it is impossible for those who were once in life, every young person in here that's still trying to do what you want to do. God already know you don't heard the word, and he already got your place in hell waiting on you. Talking about in him. Can't talk about no other house. He got it waiting on you. Every time you do something that's contrary to God, you know it right. It says truth demand a change. What demand is possible? A forceful statement. And what says that something must be done. It ain't no can be done. It said must be done. You can't keep living how you're living, walking like you're walking, and think God is all right with it. God is on mad with some of us. He don't bless some of y'all from the church with the church. But ask yourself why I hadn't changed. Ask yourself why. Why I don't do what God said when I just sung the song? He's a great God. Huh? We ain't say your man was great. We ain't say your woman was great. We ain't say your job was great. He's a great God. This is what it said. He said, but it is impossible for those who once was enlightened and has tasted the heavenly gift, has been born again, has tasted the Spirit of God, and all of a sudden, who fooled you? Who fooled you? He said, having tasted the heavenly gift and were made partake of the Holy Ghost. You was once born again, probably. But because I love this world and the things in it, I desired it. It kept calling me, come back and dance, and come back and smoke, come back and drink. You can't even be around your family more because they ain't saved. And then we go back. He said, but look what he said. He said, we're made partake of the Holy Ghost and said, have tasted the good word of God. Hey, y'all to sit down, has tasted the good word of God. Not no bad word, the good word of God. And that what gospel mean, the word gospel mean good news. And, but it ain't good news. It ain't good news when them people read the Bible and all they try to do is find fault. In other words, he that readeth his Bible to find fault with it will soon discover that the Bible find fault with him. You were never reading my Bible to learn about me or to be serve me. You was only trying to find fault in the word of God. Then what it said? It said, and have tasted the good word of God and the power of the world to come. You have tasted. He said, if they shall fall away, to renew them again unto repentance, seeing they have crucified to themselves the Son of Man, Son of God, afresh. That means you, when you talking about you saved and you love God and truth had the man to change, and then all of a sudden you had changed and you go back, you crucified Christ afresh. And now we don't say that in the church because the church don't even want to talk about sin. The church don't want to talk about wrongdoing. The church will tell you you got a 7-step plan to be rich. He said, repent, seeing they have crucified themselves, the Son of God afresh, and put him to an open shame. An open shame. And we don't want to talk about sin, but 1 Corinthians 15 and 56 said, the sting of death is sin. So if you die in sin, you're going to feel it. But because he's a great God and I'm serving him, I'm going to go to sleep in him. I'm going to just rest peacefully and waiting on him to give me my glorified body to make it heaven. While you down there talking about it's hot and it's getting hotter and it's getting hotter, and then you're going to have your own personal worm that's going to be eating on you. Your own personal worm that ain't going to never leave you, and you're going to never be unconscious to what's going on. And we want to serve maybe 50 years of sinning and then eternity in hell. I know some of y'all be talking about how much or how long y'all last, and I last all night, and I went 5 hours when I was with my woman, or I was with my man, and 5 hour pleasure, and then you die. It ain't no good then. It ain't no good then. That's why I turned my card in. In Genesis 6:5, in 6:5, it talks about back in the beginning, God was telling us then, but now it's still like that in 2017, even as Jesus died. It says in Genesis 6:5, he said, God saw that the wicked of men were great in the earth. He said, were great in the earth. Look at it now, all the killing. Young people just killing. Everybody got guns now. Don't nobody want to talk. Don't nobody want to fight. Everybody want to kill somebody. And then when they get killed somebody, and then they go to prison for the rest of their life, they might as well be dead too. But truth demands a change. It demands a change. And it said, and God saw that the wicked of men were great, was great in the earth. And every imagination of the thought of his heart was evil continuing. Y'all look at the world now. It's evil continuing. Ain't nothing good coming. Channel 3 News ain't nothing. Channel 5 News ain't nothing. CNN ain't nothing. And we got to sit back and wonder when he coming back. But if you don't believe it, you ain't looking for it. But he said in Revelation, every eye is going to be able to see him when he come back. So what would he find you doing when he come back? Where he would catch you at when he come back? And just in case your number come up before he come back, that's him coming. Truth demands a change. And God telling them in the word, I want you to be holy. In 1 Peter 1 and 15 and 16, he said, but as he which has called you is holy, so be ye holy in all manner of conversation. In other words, conversation not talking, he's talking about in lifestyle. He said, in all your conversation, all your lifestyle, even at church, you know how all of us look saved in him, and then when we go to work tomorrow, we won't look saved. When we go in Burger King or somewhere and they don't have our order right. All manner of conversation. You know, when your steak come out and you want the well done, it got blood everywhere. Is your conversation still? I heard us talking about love out here. But one thing that love do that I think we kind of missed. What you mean, Pastor? What did we miss? Divine guidance need no human help. What I'm saying is, us that know the word of God, us that say some kind of way, we try to change how we love and how we treat people. But the word, the divine guidance, the divine Bible don't need no guidance to say, this just how I am, so I'm going to do it this way. It don't need no help. It said love your enemy. It said love them that spitefully use you. It don't need no help. Then it tell her to forgive. If you don't forgive, he won't forgive you. So a lot of us got stuff in our heart that we haven't forgave. But the truth demands you to get that up. I see that the praise gone. All that. I see. He said the divine God, when he got them to write this from the Holy Ghost, he didn't need your help. When he placed the sun and the moon, he didn't need your help. When he stopped the water from coming after, he didn't need your help. When he put a baby on a woman, he didn't need nobody's help. So he don't need your help to change what he wants you to do. Truth demands a change. It demands one. It don't sit around and let you negotiate how you gonna do it. That's why he said, for we can do nothing against the truth, but for the truth. Then he come around in 1 Corinthians 13 and 6. He said, rejoice not in iniquity. Don't rejoice in nobody else's sin. Don't rejoice because somebody's going to hell or nothing like that. We shouldn't rejoice in that. Love don't do that. He said, but rejoice in the truth. Rejoice in the game changer. It'll change your game. It'll mess you up. What you used to want to do or what you like doing, it seems like it leaves you. I know some of us can't say that. I understand why. Because you sin sick. I understand why you can't rejoice when the preach word go forth. See, we good at shouting all the singing. We good at doing it. We ought to be shouting now because truth demands a change. And some of us know we ain't changed, so we got to get the la-la look. We got to start looking serious. Some of y'all don't never be glad about the word. But truth still demands a change. I don't care what age you is, how you is. You can click up with your spirit. You can click up with the devil. You can click up with your mama if you want to. You still going to bust hell wide open. It don't change. It demands a change. And we don't want to change. He said, but as he wishes, has called you as holy. So be holy in all manner of conversation. I don't care if you're Baptist, Methodist, whatever you are, Catholic, Jehovah's Witness, Muslim, you better be holy. Whatever your label is, he's the Holy God. So you tell me, you talk about Lashur, Rushur, Bashur, Terashur, Inashur, Yoshur, Ishur, whatever you want to, you better know Jesus. And all you're getting, you better get your understanding. And I'm telling y'all, we don't fear him. We don't reverence him. We don't reverence him. We come in the church and we got our own mind. But 1 Peter tells me so much about y'all. In 1 Peter 2 and 23, 1 Peter 1 and 23, he said, being born again, not of corrupted seed, but of incorruptible, by the word of God, which live and abide forever. Y'all hear that? Incorrupted. You cannot be born again and believe the Bible is corrupted. Because you are incorrupted now. And you can't believe that it contains falsehood. You know, like someone said, I believe some of the Bible. I know we got some of here. I know y'all ain't gonna raise y'all hand. But I know I trust you right there. We believe some of the Bible. But he come down here in St. John the 3rd chapter. I don't got on the road now. And it's just me stopping. He come down to tell this man named Nicodemus. He said there was a man of the Pharisee named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. Y'all hear that? A ruler of the Jews, a member of the Sanhedrin Council that had authority, huh? A man of authority of Jerusalem. But all of a sudden he met this man named Jesus. Yeah. The one who he said, great God. He met him. He said, there ain't none like you. He said, how do you do this thing that you do? And Jesus told him, you must be. Y'all hear that? Y'all hear that? It wasn't no, you could be. You almost got to think about being. And we got people in the church right now ain't born again. We got them in here. Been in the church a long time, but won't do nothing the word said, won't do nothing the priest word said, and that's why God sent this back. This Cornerstone, third time hearing truth demand a change. The third time. God keep bringing message back to us because he know one thing, we ain't doing what truth said. But he's telling you, I demand it. He told him in St. John 3 and 3, he said, and Jesus answered, said unto him, verily, verily, I say, so be it, so be it. I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom. Now, my question is to all of that ain't born again, how are we going to heaven? We sit in here and we look at TVN and we go to all these churches and they fool you that you good because you join the church. And Pastor Jay remind me, he's not looking for a steeple, he's looking for his people. He came to save the people. This building ain't going nowhere. But I want to be played with. I want to be told that I'm good. But then when you stand before God, you find out that the fool will fool you and he right down there with you. But I ain't going to hell with none of y'all. You can keep living like you want to and bust hell wide open. I won't be busting with you. He already told me in Isaiah, I'm going to be able to stand up and see the carcass down in hell. So if you're one of y'all down there, I'll be able to see you. But ain't no use you hollering at me. He told Nicodemus, you must be born again or you can't see the kingdom. He didn't say go to church again. He said you must be born again. And the church don't talk about being born again. The church talk about being baptized. And I went down, a dry devil came up, wet devil, and went right back to the club and worked that thing. Party. They told me I was changed. They told me the water bottle did it. If water did it, most of y'all might not be bathing. I went right back to the club and dropped that thing and got me a freak and went home. But John said, there's one that come after me that won't put no water on you, but I baptize you with fire. Y'all heard that? Well, why fire, Apostle Simon? Well, 1 Peter 1:7, Simon, it said that you, that the trial of your faith, he's going to try your faith by fire. He said, being much more precious than of gold, huh, that perish through. He said, it be tried with fire, might be found unto praise and honor and glory at the appearance of Jesus Christ. That's me. That ain't some of y'all. I'm going to prince for God. Oh, God, I've been waiting on you. I done went through so much on the earth, but I was just waiting on you. And since now you're here, I want to scrap my stuff and meet you. I want to walk to you with it like I've been waiting on this thing. See, y'all, a lot of y'all are going to be able to scrap that thing. I'm going to scrap that thing. I'm going to say, boy, I've been waiting on you for a long amount of time, and I have became gold. What you going to tell him? What you going to tell him? We all going to get called by the same. What you going to tell him when you stand before him? And that way he come back and said, he said, true, a real fact about something. The things are true. Then he said, change. To make or become different. Yes, sir. to make or become different. It demands. Huh? Truth makes you free. It don't set you free. It makes you free. Truth deliver you. It tell you the things that are right. And we get food. It said change. To exchange one thing for another. I put flesh and spirit. Change one thing for another. And that's why when you stand before God, he says sheets on the right, goats on the left. Now you got to tell me, how long you been bucking? How long you been bucking what truth said? How long you been bucking what the word said? And that's why people don't want to come nowhere with truth at, because truth gets your butt naked and says, you a sinner. Truth said, you going to hell. And they try to get mad with me, but I'm just a mailman. I ain't never seen nobody shoot their mailman by good power, disconnect. You just get in, go in the house and say, well, it's 5 o'clock. Lights off. And when God, what I'm telling you right now, it's going to be lights off. I ain't going to be the one cut them off. He is. This is what he said in Deuteronomy 32:4. He said, he is the rock. His work is perfect. For all his ways are judgment. Now y'all hear that? And don't nobody want nobody to say nothing about their wrongdoing. I got people now trying to go to work to miss church. I hope they listen to YouTube. They going to work to miss church. When it used to be an insult for the job to have them work on Sunday. Now all of a sudden, I'm praising. Because I want to make it at 6 o'clock because Apostle Simon might get me at 11. It said right there, the whole truth, nothing but the truth. Ain't no use me telling some of it. Huh? Ain't no use me telling some of y'all. Some of y'all want to play with God. But God ain't the one to play with. Because you ain't playing with me because I'm not a tucker tar. You can't buy me from Walmart. We playing. And that what Nicodemus said. He is a ruler, a saint, he's a counsel. Had the scroll, knew about God. But listen what he said in the 4th verse. He said, Nicodemus said unto him, how can a man be born when he is old? See, he thinking fleshly. And that when God be speaking to us, we be thinking fleshly. Well, do you really believe in hell? Well, why everybody believes in heaven? Ain't nobody never said, do you really believe that's a heaven? They came from the same writer. But truth demand a change. And that's what Luke 19:13 said. He said, and he called his 10 servants and delivered them 10 pounds and said unto them, occupy till I come. In other words, he demanded them to occupy until he can come. He demanded me to occupy till he come. He demanded you to witness about him until he come. He demanded you. But some of us started good, but we didn't finish well. All right. Help us, God. We had the mess that you knew, or knew, and it said, will you finish? Yeah. Some of y'all already done gave up the ghost. Some of y'all ain't even trying to finish. As long as y'all can be with who y'all want to be with, and as long as y'all can go where y'all want to do, and as long as y'all got a couple of dollars, y'all ain't studying the church. You ain't studying Jesus. I'm talking to this house. We ain't studying. We ain't studying. Know why? Me come first. When he paid a price for me, I gave up my rights. My life became a slave to him. And don't nobody else handle me but him. You can't say that. But truth still demand a change. It still tell you you got to change. It don't matter how old you are when you die or how young you are. When you come into knowledge that you can work an iPhone and you can work a computer, you can make a choice to serve him. You know, it made my heart feel good when I heard them say, turn to such and such. And the little kids, all the kids were back there when they were talking about turning. And all the kids were turning. They said, turn to Deuteronomy. And all the children were going to Deuteronomy. And here's some old, young, older people now don't know nothing about the Bible. We had a lady over there at a church over there. She sung every hymn and war. They told her to turn to Hebrew. She's still looking for it. It made my heart feel good to know these young people know what the Bible is. We ain't sending him running to the bathroom. We ain't sending him with phone playing with. The only one play with phone is him, the teenager. They try to sit on their seat and have, you know, they can text from the seat and look at you right there. They don't even know, they have to know where the number's at. Holy Ghost don't tell on them, and they still going to hell because they're disobedient to God. In God's house, think they got somebody fooled. Self, why? I have not changed. You start asking yourself why. This is what 1 Corinthians 15 and 33 said. Be not deceived. Evil communication corrupt good manner. Who you around. Who you talking to. Who you communicate with. It corrupts good manners. It mess you up. One day you all about God. The next night you talking to somebody all talking all crazy. Now you all sideways. Plan well, live well. Plan bad, live bad. That's what God said. He got the best policy. You ain't got to research what God have the best insurance. You ain't got to worry wonder how good God is and how good voodoo is, how good Muhammad is, or how my own self is, because most of y'all your own God. You don't answer to nobody but yourself. Ain't we in here? Talk to me. Y'all talk back to me. Let me know I ain't preaching to myself. Two things people don't like, truth and a chain. This is what 1 Corinthians 3 and 11 said. It said, for other foundation can no man lay that is laid, which is in Christ Jesus. So why everybody got all these new translations? They laying another foundation. Because we sit here and say, I don't understand the King James, because you know what back there in the old days and this and that, and it said Dow and D. Well, I can get a new translation. There's some of them names back in the Old Testament I just can't pronounce. I pass by them. I said, shoot. I read the rest of them, I'm going by my business. But when it comes to D and thou, we ain't got no problem now. You must be born again, because the mystery of the scripture is hid from them in the law. When a sinner's trying to read the Bible, he can't understand it, because the first thing he needs to do is repent and get his life right. I owe God a praise. I don't care how the devil feel about me. I really don't care. I got a text from Trey. He told me, Apostle Jeff, preach the word, because the enemy can't change what God done did. Can't change your preach word. He ain't know what I'll preach, but truth is a game changer. So I come to change life. I ain't coming around here to make y'all just keep walking around here with sin, coming in here shacking, just had sex, just been drinking last night, been in the club, booty shaking, and then you come in the church, waving your hand. Put them sinners' hand down. Put them nasty hand down. You know what you've been doing. And then want to come in here, been smoking, been drinking, been homemonging, everything, shooting dice, everything. And then come in the church, and then want to wave to a holy God. What do a holy God want with an unholy person? Divine and guidance need no human help. He was God then, and he's still God. And he ain't gonna breach none of his promises. Y'all heard that word, didn't it? Y'all know I don't really say stupid like that. Boy, wake up. Hold your head up, stand up or something. Going to sleep in church. You gonna drop that baby. You gotta stop playing. Why go to sleep on God when God talking? About the plan now. That's what God said. There's no room for debate. Only one have debate is president and all these people like that. When it comes to God, ain't no debate. We try to debate God with, I understand how God is, but I understand that God just say you shouldn't do this, but I understand that your butt gonna be hot in hell. That's what your butt gonna be. Your butt gonna be hot. That's all it's gonna be. God ain't studying you talking about no butt. But what? Who you is? I just came to bless his name today. I owe him a praise. He come back and Nicodemus said unto him, how can a man be born again when he's old? Can he enter the second time in his mother womb? Jesus said, dummy. He said, very, very, I say unto you, except the man is born of the water and of the spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. He cannot. Y'all hear that? And now the church is full of flesh. I wouldn't go no church. They ain't going to preach hell about me. I ain't going to go no church. They ain't going to tell me. I ain't going in the door. Because the only reason why we go to them church, we don't want the truth. And we don't want to change. To come in here, you got to wear some big man drawers. You got to be a man to come up in here and hear this. Ain't that right, Deacon Hall? You got to be a man. Only a man going to want the truth. Real man love God. That go for y'all women too, because he don't look at female and male. He don't look at no female and male. That's why I don't understand why they say a woman can't preach. Well, when all the disciples went to hear, The woman has to take the first message. What we doing hiding? This is what he said in the 6th verse of St. John 3 and 6. He said, that which is born of the flesh is flesh. Huh? That's why he told you need to be born again. He said, that was born of the spirit is spirit. Marvel not. Y'all hear that? Turn with me to Acts 26. He told Nicodemus, Sanhedrin Council, you must be born again. He said, truth was the manner that Nicodemus changed. And y'all know Nicodemus became one of God's disciples. You know, they only said the 12 seen God, so they said the only 12 apostles, all that, you know, they don't know what they're talking about. Because see, Paul was one of the 12. They just been reading the wrong. They don't know. They've been going to school trying to learn this. It take the Holy Ghost. That's why me, I just sit up under it. I said, feed me, Lord. Feed me. Let me tell you what St. John, y'all going to Acts 26, but St. John 3 and 19, because I don't want y'all to pause nowhere. It said, and this is the condemnation that light has come into the world, and all men love darkness rather than light, because their deeds are evil. That's why they don't want to come here. It's a light in here. So if I come in here, it gonna shine on my darkness. You know, that's why I keep telling y'all, some of y'all husband is messed up, some of y'all wife is messed up, you messing your children up. Pastor just told you, he said it's time to rise up. Why you think your children are so messed up? It's just like I told you about the little boy shifting the gear. His daddy thought he didn't know, but he'd sit there and watch the daddy instead of daddy. Then when the daddy gave him the key, he could shift the car. Daddy said, how you learn that? Because I watch you. So when you doing stuff at home, like I said, you come to church and hear God's word, then you go home and be nasty, you cussing. Yeah. Or you in the home, oh, what the children have to say? This is the way it's supposed to be? But truth demands a change. It shouldn't be going on in your house. Oh, I know I stepped in somewhere then. I stepped in somewhere then, but you know, I might can't swim good in real water, but I swim pretty good with God. He my preserving. I just sit on the floor. Take me where you're going, God. Take me where you're going. This is what Acts said. He come back in Acts 26. We're going to start at the 12th verse. It said, whereupon as I went to the master with authority and commission from the chief priest. Now this Paul, Saul now. He went there. He was going to persecute the church. He was going to crucify the church. But truth. He was on his way. He had got order from the devil. He was on his way. But true. What you mean, Apostle? Let's fast forward. The 14th verse. It said, when we were all fall to the earth. They say it fell our heart, but they don't say that. But I'm going on about it. He said, I heard a voice speaking unto me, saying in the Hebrew tongue, Saul, Saul, Cornerstone, Cornerstone, why persecuted thou me? He asking all y'all in here, Trey, why persecuted me? Deacon McGee, why persecuted me? Samitra, why persecuted me? Huh? Why persecuted me? Joanne, why persecuted me? Helena, why persecuted me? He saying, why y'all persecute me even after y'all heard the truth? Jesus hadn't died when Saul was, but he don't die with us. And y'all don't heard truth. And no truth to man. So why you hadn't changed? Why you hadn't changed? That's what God said. Why? Apostle Simon's job is to open the eyes of the people. This is what he said. He said, Saul, why persecuted thou me? It is hard for thee to keep kicking against the priest. Keep kicking against me. Keep kicking. Every time I show you something, you kick against it. Come on down here to the 16th verse. But then when truth came, then when the voice came, it said, but rise. See, truth demands a change. He said, please get up, Paul. Please get up, Saul. He said, but rise. He's telling us today. Pastor told her, rise. Huh? He just told us, rise up. Now I come back, I'm just telling you what the scripture said, because Pastor didn't know what I was talking about. The proof that our faith is real is a changed life. You can't say you don't change and your life's still the same. Oh yeah, let me come on down here. And this in red, so y'all know in y'all vocation the Bible study when y'all was young, red means Jesus talking, right? Well, this is him. He said, but rise and stand upon thy feet, for I have appeared unto thee for this purpose. I have sent upon some to preach this message to y'all again. I'm appearing to y'all again. Truth the man of change, and all y'all ain't gonna change, I'm gonna get you. All y'all still doing you want to from the younger to the old, I'm going to get you. Because my word, it said the day that you hear my voice, harden not your heart. Don't rebel. And y'all been rebelling, and God said, I'm going to get you. I'm talking to the house now. He going to get you because he appeared again for this purpose. Y'all hear what he said? He said, to make thee a minister and a witness, both on these things which thou have seen and those things in which I will appear unto thee. Deliver thee from the people. He'll deliver you from that. Don't go be talking about, well, I'm just don't want to be right because you know I'm in young and I'm in the school and everybody in the school doing wrong. He said, I'll deliver you from that. Because truth demands. Don't y'all be scared to say it. It's already get you because it's in your earlobe. Faith come by. Faith come by. Faith come by. So you, did you hear? Okay, faith. Faith, 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 faith. I feel pretty good. I see some of y'all looking crazy. He said, from the Gentile, unto whom now I send thee, to open the eye and to turn them from darkness to light and from the power of Satan unto God. That's what preachers are supposed to be doing. We're supposed to be turning people from darkness to light. He said, unto Satan, that they may receive forgiveness of sin and inherit among them which is sanctified by faith that is in me. So that is in me. He look what he said. And whereupon, O King Agrippa, I was not disobedient unto the heavenly vision, but shunned first unto them on the master and at Jerusalem and throughout all the coast of Judea and then to the Gentile, that they should repent and turn to God and do the work meet for repentance. He said, that's what I came to do. But truth, the man of change. This man was going to kill the church. He was going to wreck up the church. But truth came to him. And the man of the change, he said, who art thou, Lord? He said, I am Jesus. Who thou kick against? Who y'all kicking against in here? Who you kicking against? Y'all think y'all kicking against me because y'all go to work and go hide yourself. Don't talk to me. Y'all think y'all... He said, the day that you hear, you already done heard. And goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life. Can I just tell you what 1 Timothy 3 and 15 said? He said, but if I tarry long, that thou mayest know how thou ought to behave thyself in the house of God, which is the church of the living God, the pillar and grounding. So what's our problem in Cornerstone? The truth, the whole truth, nothing but the truth. Why some are still like we are? Huh? Why some are still want to do what we want to do when the word been grounded in you? Huh? Y'all know we shouldn't be shacking. And I know y'all don't call shacking spending the night. It's shacking. It's shacking. If he's spending the night 2 or 3 days out of the week, even though he's going home to other folks, it's shacking. If he's staying 1 day out of month, if he got in a pair of drawers there, it's shacking. This is what it said in Romans 1 and 18. He said, for the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodly. Y'all hear that? He ain't said one. It took one sin for Adam and Eve to get put out of the garden. One sin. They ain't do no 2 or 3 sin. He one sin. He told them, do not eat of the tree of good and evil. He's telling y'all, don't sin. Should we continue sin that grace abound? God forbid. Truth demands a change.
Pastor, I just can't live right, man. My flesh. Well, I got the same flesh you got. They both crave for the same thing. But that's why he told you to be born again. Because that word flesh is flesh. It gonna want what it want. If I can get me a potato pie right now, boy, look at him. By 3 or 4. Cold, gone. Just got to give him round three.
It said, for the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodly and all unrighteous. Well, why the church ain't saying that? Men who hold the truth in unrighteousness. They know it's right. They know this is what God said, but they don't change some things. Because all the church now want a concert. The church got scroll life in the church now. Because they still want to feel they're in the club. They booming a little bit. They got coming to shows in the church now. Coming to show. Here you got a coming to show in God how. You already coming enough with your preaching. You don't need no coming. You don't need no man to come in with no coming to show. The preaching you doing is coming in. Teach them. That's what they said. And look what they said. And we said, well, what is truth then? Just like Pilate. In St. John 18 and 38, he said, Pilate said unto them, what is truth? And when he had said this, he went out again unto the Jew and said unto them, in him I find no fault. In the Bible, I find no fault, y'all. I don't know about y'all. Y'all reading the five fault and then listen to these people telling you, you ain't got to pay tithes. You know everybody don't want to pay tithes because that means you keep that $10. Shoot. I was glad when they said you ain't paying tithes. Y'all know how we get. Some of y'all ain't paying tithes. Some of y'all making $2,000 and then say you got to get $200. Nah, bro. I'm gonna pay my due. I'm gonna get him about $5. And here you talking about you love God. You're talking about God woke you up. No, your mama woke you up. God ain't wake you up. You know, you don't love him like that. That was said. Truth is a game changer. That was St. John 1 and 17 said. It said, for the law was given by Moses, but grace and truth came by Jesus Christ. Y'all can talk about Moses and Elijah and John and Paul and all that, but truth and grace came by the Savior. And now we're trying to change the name to Shoshua, Habui, something. Well, just name him Terry. Just name whatever you want to name. That's where we're at. But listen, and we get mad with God when he's bringing truth and the man's a train. And then when we keep ignoring him, he get fearing. What did he do then, Apostle? In Revelation 3 and 19, he said, as many as I love, I rebuke. I chase them. Huh? You hear that? I chase them. Be zealous, therefore, and repent. He said, I try to run you in a hole where you will repent. Yes, truth is a game changer. I don't know what your game was before you came here. Okay. But baby, we full coat pressing. We taking the water all the way up the whole coat. We pressing all the way down. I'm pressing this up out. Y'all know they would say that would happen anyway when they take grapes and stuff. They pressing and squeeze the juice. That's how they get wine. So God's trying to press all that flesh out of y'all with the word. He's trying to get rid of that. Flesh of y'all, and y'all hold on that flesh. I'm like, I ain't been there. I love my flesh, God. You just, and God keep breaking word. That's why some of y'all stiff neck and rebellious right now. That's why you're stiff neck and rebellious. You don't want to submit to God. But truth instead of demanding a change. This is what it said in 1 Corinthians 2 and 5. It said that your faith should not stand in the wisdom of man, but in the power of God. Because truth demands a change. Y'all ain't hear me. I ain't found no fault in him yet. You know, not that I was looking for, but I just ain't find none. 2 Timothy tells us a whole lot. 2 Timothy 3 and 7 said, ever learning and never able to come into the knowledge of truth. Ever learning and never able to come to the knowledge of truth. Demand a forceful statement in which said that something must be done or given. A strong need for something. True wealth is found only in God's grace. Only in God's grace. He's telling us something. But as I come to a close, 2 Timothy. Y'all got it? 2 Timothy. Y'all gonna get it now. Don't be slow. 2 Timothy. I'm gonna do 3. And 16, it demands a change. And we heard the message one time and folks said, what are we going to do with the Bible? What are we going to do with it? We're going to ignore it. We're going to change it. We're going to do what man said. He said, put no confidence in man. He's telling us that. But he's telling you right here in 2 Timothy 3 and 16, he said, all scripture is given by the inspiration of God, and it's proper for doctrine, teaching, for reproof, for correction, for the instruction of in righteousness. He said that the means of God, the preacher, be perfect and thoroughly, furnished unto all good work. He got Nicodemus. He told Nicodemus, truth demands a change. He came over to Saul and said, truth demands a change. When he called me, he let me know one thing. Apostle Simmel, truth demands a change. Then what you want, God?